10 seconds remain. Radiant team ban. Dire team ban. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Radiant team pick.
Night Stalker.
Dire team pick.
Beastmaster.
Dire team pick.
Bounty Hunter.
Radiant team pick.
Well, folks, we're into game two. Let's get into the Dota. We have got Danish Bears versus Broodmothers. And we've already got some picks flying out. They've managed to get their hands on the Beastmaster, Bounty Hunter, and Nightstalker gonna beat Danish Bears open, and that was their first pick. They clearly didn't enjoy playing against it. Broodmothers have done their homework, banning the Alchemist and then changing things up with the Darkseer ban. Deciding that hero has been causing them problems. The Alchemist is because Pingvacek's Alchemist is fantastic. It was banned before Alchemist got banned. Teams got buffed. Teams would ban the Alchemist against Pingvacek. After the Alchemist has gotten nerfed, teams are still banning the Alchemist against Pingvacek, although it's being usually third, fourth, sometimes even first, second ban against most teams.
So, 10 seconds remaining.
Excuse me. Something a lot of teams don't want to deal with. Phoenix and Doom also being banned out by Danish Bears. Phoenix did not make it through this time. Danish Bears agree that they had a lot of trouble with it, so I'm gonna just jump right in there. And for Danish Bears, it's a pretty solid support, maybe an offlaner there in that Nightstalker combo for them. But Broodmothers, I really like the Bounty Hunter. When you pair it up with the Beastmaster, that's a lot of vision you're gonna be having all game long. Now, Broodmothers, they had a lot of trouble against the Klinks last game. It's just a bit of a problematic hero if you don't have the resources to continually buy dust, but of course, with a lot of vision being given to you by the track, feels like it is much more flexible. So they're going to ban the Sven, always a solid carry, and next the Witch Doctor comes out. Another hero we see banned a lot, so... But for either team, they're not showing too much with these pickups. Broodmothers can actually still go for an early push lineup, although they have to be a little bit careful with the Bounty Hunter, making sure that Bounty Hunter actually gets levels. Your Bounty Hunter is useless before the track is up. Arguably even before level 7, since you want that maxed out shuriken so that you can track everyone and throw it around. Really help out in early engagement since it does a lot of damage, but often if the roaming isn't so successful, if Bounty Hunter can't find a kill or two, You're going to be level 6, maybe 14 minutes in, and that can be really rough. Broodmother's also saying that they are not looking to draft a million pieces of lockdown. They're going to ban out that Ember Spirit.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Broodmother's just picking their cards carefully. Whatever secondary support they go with, they probably do want a bit of lockdown. I don't mind the Jakiro. We've been seeing a lot of Jakiro play, and it does seem like a solid pickup. It's just not been transferring. Sorry, way to say it. The macro pyre seems to sometimes be the letdown. We've seen some really impressive ones, but it feels like out of all the skills, the macro pyre is the hardest to have a super effective impact on. Maybe you need to draft your team a little bit around holding them in that macro pyre, so.
Dire team pick.
Well, in Boca, gonna be that ban out for Danish Bears. Pretty interesting. I don't...
10 seconds remaining.
I don't think they're super concerned about it, but maybe just saying, hey, we, again, just don't like dealing with that hero, and if we can find the space to ban it out, we're banning it out. Broodmothers go with the Disruptor, so this is really interesting. They don't actually have a lot of lockdown. Disruptor will deter certain mids. It would have actually probably deterred the Ember Spirit quite a bit, because you can glimpse back into Static Storm, but... makes it more difficult for Danish Bears to pick up something mobile like the Co-op, like a Storm Spirit. Not that I think they go Storm Spirit, although we have been seeing Storm come back a little bit.
Reserve time.
Well. Or Danish Bears, they opt for the Jakiro. They've got a good amount of lockdown here. Having a look, it's... none of it's though... obviously, once you max out the Ice Cloth, it gets longer. But having your Shore lockdown, your Shore stuns be stuff like Fiend's Grip, which has a long cooldown.
10 seconds
remaining. Ice Cloth, which, of course, Kill Shot, Mini Stun on the Void.
Remaining.
It can be a little bit worrisome, but right now they do have some good control, even if Broodmothers pick up something strong as a core, like the Juggernaut again. Although, both sides haven't really touched on the Slog, someone who we actually see banned out a lot these days, so I'm a little surprised. Broodmothers taking advantage of that. Now, Puck, as long as Puck sees the Nightstalker coming, you should be fine, but... there is totally a window there to catch out the Puck and make sure that you get that 5 seconds crippling fear at nighttime, of course, on the Puck.
5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Danish Bears, they got some decent ways to handle Apocalypse. Them picking up a core that they really like. Ace has a pretty wide pool. It's actually something I really enjoy seeing at lower levels of Dota. I'd say both of these teams that are on the cusp of being able to compete with teams like Adfinem and Empire, but often losing those games, they do take the co-op into this, the Disruptor. Wasn't really expecting that. But I was going to say, I think that it's interesting because a lot of these kind of tier 2, if you want to call them that, teams on the cusp becoming a bit better, they seem to have wider hero pools. Maybe because of the way they scrim, maybe because the competition is lower, but...
Radiant team pick.
gonna be the gyro band out again. Something I find kind of funny since Broodmothers didn't have much success with that in earlier games, but the Juggernaut, something Broodmothers don't deal with themselves, especially with their kind of limited lockdown. And Danish Bears, they could try for something like the Slock here. A lot of things you can purge out, often good against the Beastmaster in lane. But it's gonna be a Slaughter. Interesting pickup, it's gonna help them with the Bounty Hunter some, and it brings a lot of utility to the game. And of course Slaughter can output quite a bit of damage, but there is this awkward moment where physical damage on Danish Bears will really just be outscaled by something like a Phantom Lancer. Players gonna be picking up their heroes, seeing where they go. They do, it feels like, have a big problem on Danish Bears. They don't really have a great answer to this Phantom Lancer other than get a Sonic Wave throughout all of them, you know? So
10 seconds.
Gonna be a difficult one, I think, if the game goes late, but Danish Bears do definitely have an opportunity to try and dominate their lanes. PL needs a bit of time to come online. He's not someone who's going to be too problematic until about at least 15 minutes into the game, unless something goes really topsy-turvy. Now, looking at this Bounty Hunter, I'm expecting a lot of vision to come out from Danish Bear, since they have supports who can sustain it, like the Bane, who doesn't really need much help, and the Jakiro, who doesn't either. It still could be a pain. Obviously, the co-op, she has a way of blinking away, but maybe the Bounty Hunter gets on top of her, uses that Janotta slow. She underestimates the damage coming out of the Bounty Hunter and the puck. Things can go south. I do think a lot of the other lanes are a bit harder to kill. Trying to kill a Night Stalker can always be difficult, and then similarly with the Slaughter. No, just nice and paused. Both teams are usually okay with these types of pauses. They'll discuss strategy, just kind of figure out where exactly they want to go, who is buying a TP out to place a ward. It just cracks me up sometimes, because it really is something that a lot of teams do. Even in the professional scene on LAN, sometimes you have these pauses that are kind of mostly tactical. So. Well, Yoya is going to be the one to TP out. The Disruptor may have just seen this. It doesn't look like Ill saw it. That is... I have never seen this ward before. That's about all the vision it gives. It's a very odd one. Raya's going to be standing here, relaxed right next to him. And this one, of course, right on the edge of the camp. Pretty weird, to say the least.
Seconds to battle.
Well. Let's get into it after I'm just poking around at the woods. Let's do some introductions. We've got Ryze playing on that Bane for Danish Bears. Pingvacek on Quap. Ace playing that Slaughter. Noya on the Jakiro. And of course, last but not least, Rotten on that offlane Nightstalker. Going to lane with a good amount of regen. For Broodmothers, we've got Relax, their Drafter, playing that Bounty Hunter. Tanks on that Beastmaster. BL being played by Focus. Ill playing that Disruptor. And finally, Kiza on the Puck. We'll see how this mid matchup goes. Obviously, Puck has some easy ways to dodge a lot of what Quap dishes out with the phase shift. So I'm expecting Puck to do pretty well. But both of them have good damage, so the last hits back and forth should be pretty easy, even. Meanwhile, up on top, Rotten already taking quite a bit of damage. He dewatered the ward over here. Focus as well, getting low, will throw a loss at Rotten, but it looks like Focus, one more auto attack. Noya coming in on the other side, there's the dual breath. There will be a salve going out on Focus, but now the auto attacks, it looks like it'll be enough. First blood going in favor of the Nightstalker. He's gonna salve up. If they're not careful, they'll catch ill as well. Nightstalker will have that salve knocked out. There is the Void coming out. A few more auto attacks, one more from the Jakiro. No, the Fairy Fire will make it impossible to kill. Still, a really good job there done by Danish Bears offlane. And this is what they need to do. This PL needs to be shut down. There's no way around it. Disrupted your suicides to the neutrals, getting that false TP home. That false send back and... yeah. Ace. I mean, just be not terribly contested with his last hitting. Definitely doing a bit easier time than the PL. Pingvacek actually taking quite a bit of harassment from Kiza. And up in top again, PL taking a lot of damage from Noya. There is going to be Bounty Hunter coming on in. They'll see it with the Sentry, of course. They already know he's there, but it looks like this could be the death of Noya. The Thunder Strike doing a lot of damage. The salving in between, saving his life. And now Rotten poking his head out to say hello. Fortunately for Bounty Hunter, didn't get a kill. We'll give the Bounty a place to get level 2, so we'll have Janata next time. Meanwhile, Bane just brain sapping the poor boar down there. Beastmaster's getting plenty of experience too. It's not all bad things for Broodmothers. The Beastmaster's doing pretty dang well when it comes to farm. In top lane, PL has started to catch back up, getting some good CS here. Bounty Hunter coming around. There's gonna be the Donata onto Noya. They've got a really nice kinetic field forcing him around the long way. Dual breath does fly out. He's gonna try to take ill with him, and they will in fact get the Disruptor. So it's something going the way of the Nightstalker, but of course Disruptor got that other kill. Relax gonna be able to TP out just fine. And again, Focus some pressure off the lane with the Jakiro dead. Now, on game plans for Danish Bears, they're going to want to be fighting a lot. They've got a team lineup for it. They're going to be rocking the Slaughter. Depending on how this bomb goes, might decide to rush the Blink. But we've seen a lot of safe lane Slaughters prefer to build up into a Omelette. Ooh, this is painful for Phantom Lancer being forced home almost longer than dying. And it does feel like Danish Bears will need to take advantage of individual pickoffs to try to get stuff to happen. Found the end of just planting a tree like a cutie pie. Well, for Broodmillers, if they can hold out, I really want to stress this. Their game plan really can just be hold out. Make sure that they stay in it, because the longer they're in it, the better their odds get. The Phantom Lancer is really difficult for this lineup by Danish Bears to take down. Their AoE is mostly just co-op spells. The face, oh gosh, the boy, will he catch one more auto attack? Would have killed Ill. Chikiro trying to get in range for it, but no such luck. Instead, just gonna have to turn around and go and focus. Really nice kinetic field coming up there from the Disruptor. Being very aggressive on Puck Bane, thinking about coming around just, I think, for some harassment. Realizing that Slaughter doesn't need a whole heap of help in this bottom lane. Slaughter and Bane deciding they're not able to zone the Beast Monster, so just leaving Slaughter alone. It's a little bit scary, but Slaughter also has the amp damage, so anytime the Beast Monster's out of position at all, you're gonna be taking a heavy beating. We have rotations. The Bounty Hunter sees it all. And Ryze does have dust, but not going to be enough. Especially when they're not quite sure where the Bounty Hunter is.
Your armor melts away.
I like seeing that Ace just making sure to do whatever he can to get every single last hit that he needs. Ping the check. In the mid lane, Puck is ahead, and we've seen this. They're trading hits mostly, not too far behind on Pingvatek. Phantom Lancer goes down again on the top lane. It's just so little this. Okay, did they really just have their smoke blown? I think they were trying to catch up to the courier. And then they thought the Bounty Hunter was there. And all of this is a series of unfortunate events for Ill, who is silenced up. That's a 5-second one since it's that first nighttime. And now Ill, one more auto attack, they'll bring him down. Rotten is dominating, has every single kill for his team. Hasn't died yet. That is one fat Nightstalker, already level 6. Something you often worry about in the offlane Nightstalker. That level 6 timing, especially if it's a dual lane. Relax, stalking up the Slaughter. He does decide to go into the omelette. It was kind of funny, Slaughter had saved up a lot of gold. We see a lot of different players go different ways. I think it's just seeing how the pace of the game is going. Maybe would have gone for the blink if things are going worse with the PL and deciding that they really did need a response to that. But since they have killed the PL twice now, and they don't seem to be having much trouble with it, I can understand Ace saying, hey, whatever, we're gonna just go for the omelette and wait a little bit. And it's true, their pressure is relieved with the PL being further behind. You can see PL is 6th on that net worth chart, so they know they have some time. Nighttime is popped, and Skanks knows there is bad news coming his way. There's gonna be a Slithering Crush and amp damage and one more auto attack from the Nightstalker. Rotten still has every single one of his team's kills. They're not done yet. PL taking a lot of damage in the top lane. There's gonna be a glimpse back onto Ryze. They throw out the Nightmare. It's toggled off by Ill, trying to make sure that other folks can catch up. Nightstalker is coming. Ill should go down here. Nightstalker gonna go onto Focus. Throws out an Urn Charge. One more auto attack. He manages to get the PL. Dust thrown out onto Relax. We'll see. Can Rotten get another one? Unfortunately, Rotten has missed out on one kill, I believe. Ryze managed to get that one. Still, this is a 7-0 Nightstalker, 9 minutes in, almost a kill a minute. He is keeping up with Slaughter's farm despite only having 23 creeps, and this is going to begin to present a problem for Broodmothers. He can already start working on his Aghanim Scepter. If he keeps getting this many kills, he's going to have it in about 10 minutes. Oh, Okay, Puck trying to use the Dream Coil to catch out Ace, there's the silence as well. Ace almost toggles Primal Roar, TP's coming in, where's the Nightmare? Oh goodness, Puck jumps on out, Ace just almost toggling away, they're gonna pick off Beast Monster. That was two ultimates dropped, unable to kill off the Slaughter. It's looking grim for Brood Mothers. They were doing great, did so well. Up against Polarity, took some good fights Radiant's against Rebels, and yeah, 5,000 gold behind. Oh, and Skanks looking for more, a couple more auto attacks. Quaff thinking about it, could just blink over to the side, is gonna go for the scream, gets a kill to her name. It is 10 to 1, 10 minutes in, 5,000 plus gold going the way of Danish Bears. They're poisoned in position. They do need to convert some more objectives. They've taken the safe lane tower. They're now going to work on the tier 1 bottom. Look there. Other than the level 1 axe, there's not too much Beastmaster can do here in an attempt to deter this push. Does have Bounty Hunter coming down with him. This is what we talked about. Bounty Hunter, I think, actually doing a really impressive job. Almost level 6, but it's not enough. The stun onto Kiza. Puck in a lot of trouble. Primal Roar comes out. Puck, is he gonna live here? One more auto attack. They do manage to blow up the Slaughter's head. Puck dies, buys back, trying to come back into this fight. But suddenly, a lot of members of Danish Bears are here. Rise, trying to run it off. There's the scream. The Sonic Wave comes on through, and Puck is looking like it might be a dieback. Beastmaster and Bounty Hunters hit the deck. Puck goes down before he can orb on over. And that was a dieback. The only survivor, the PL. Only survives because he's off elsewhere on the map. Radiant's top tower is under attack. Another 1,500 gold swing in favor of Danish Bears. And this one looking like a stop. Danish Bears know we all want to head over and watch Epicenter, and they're trying to make it possible. Dire's bottom tower is under attack. Danish Bears. Getting good damage on that tier 3. Tier 2. What? We're awake. I'll guess who's coming to town. It's Bane. Going to have vision broken. But what's Focus gonna do? Just sitting there. Doesn't even have the bots. It looks like he's going for the bots. And they're just not happening. Four Brood Mothers to get back into this game. Obviously, a lot of different things need to happen, but we're starting to get to the point where we may have to talk about high ground. Also, defending the Roshan Pit for Danish Bears. This is super easy for us to take. Oh, Puff tries to Dream Coil up Noya. Will they even get this kill on a support? Noya just going for the TP away. Manages to get out the silence, not in time from Kiza. And now the Puck in a lot of trouble. One more auto attack will bring that Puck down. They just don't get anything working on this map for Brood Mothers. Bane just waiting for some support. There's gonna be some auto attacks going their way. Quap is here. The scary Night Stalker is here as well. Sonic Wave, perfect lineup for it. Quap could go for it. There it goes. Sonic Wave coming out. Jumps in with the scream as well. Two already on the deck. Night Stalker gonna bring down another one in the Beast Monster. Relax, only getting away due to that Invis. The TP out is cancelled by Puck. And relax, there's nothing to do here. Quap already almost has an Orchid. We're seeing a Night Stalker who's sitting on almost the full Aghanim Scepter, 350 gold away from it. And Slaughter, only being half involved in this. Oh gosh, Puck gonna go down again. Night Jakiro actually gets that one with the dart, even though Night Stalker had the own charge out there. That's the other thing, Night Stalker been throwing out own charges left and right already. Well, not already, still has four looking around, and you'd think this is almost sorted by teams. Only the Bane low on the net worth chart. Also, half the deaths of the team. 1,000 gold per minute lead coming out for Danish Bears. Almost everybody on Broodmothers just has brown boots. Of course, that makes sense for the Beastmaster, but not terribly viable for anyone else. Saving Grace, track is up on the Bounty Hunter. Might be able to hit that level 7 soon. As we talked about, level 7, things change a lot for the Bounty Hunter there. Can track everyone up, can shuriken effectively. Fortunately, they know where you are, relax. They know exactly where you are. The dust comes out, there's the amp damage, rotten. Oh, the toggle with the boars, but it's not enough. Relax, just gonna fall. Maybe they'll kill the boars as well for funsies. And Danish Bears just extend their lead. Oh, Slithering Crush off the mark. Focus gonna be able to just wander away. It's coming down to high ground defense. I think the best chance they have is track everyone up, shuriken on through, try to keep orbing the creep waves down with the puck, but this puck doesn't even have a veil, has no way of really getting rid of all of these creeps, and jumping forwards with the orb, using the jaunt to jump forwards and get in position to waning rift the creep wave is a dangerous off. Here comes that roast that we talked about for Danish Bears, super easy with the amp damage. And I was worried about their ability to force objectives. Well, they've taken every... taken the outer towers with ease.
Radiant's top tower.
There is nothing stopping Danish Bears from the high ground. I'm gonna pop that nighttime. They see you, relax. The void gonna stop that TP. There is no escape from the Night Stalker here, and relax will just be forced to 1v1 the beast himself. Night Stalker TP's away. I think not. He thought he had that kill with the lost auto attack. Oh, he was trying to come in and help out, but there will be the TP away. Kills all over the map, even down the Jakiro. Seeing that there are three dead on Broodmothers, I think they can push this on Danish Bears, and they have to know it. Very aware of their strengths. Danish Bears, looking like a good one. They are almost 20,000 net worth ahead, over 12,000 experience. They do end up waiting for the Jakiro. They might be looking for a pickoff here. Obviously not terribly difficult with the blink picked up by Slaughter, but Broodmothers may just not leave their base, in which case Danish Bears may be forced to slow siege this. Okay, there we go. There's gonna be the Primal Roar onto Slaughter. A huge kill for Broodmothers. Managing to catch this one out. Bane thinking about coming in. Oh, the entirety of Danish Bears are thinking about coming in. Maybe getting a bit cocky there. They do manage to catch out the Beastmaster there. Dual Breath comes out as well. The Static Storm does land perfectly on top of two of them, but the Sonic Wave hits four. Quap jumps in with the screen follow-up and will just auto-attack them down. You can't get better than that. You just can't ask for a better Sonic Wave. And it looks like Slaughter may have just been the sacrificial lamb. Now Danish Bears, they have to know that it's time to finish it out. They had a game yesterday that got drawn out for an hour. And here comes the push. Or not. They don't seem to be want to take the bait on Danish Bears. They have the Aegis for another minute and a half. They've got to grab it by the horns. You really don't want to extend this out against a PL, who's now almost got the defusal. Although, of course, the PL needs a lot more than that to live here. Oh, Puck jumping in, drops the Dream Coil just on the Noia. There's the Silence on the Kiza. A nice kinetic field, forcing the Night Stalker to walk all the way around, but doesn't look like he's catching any flies with that, honey. Primal Roar onto Nightstalker, PL trying to do what he can with his illusions, but Plop jumping in on the back lines, picks up the Puck, shows off that BKB ping attack. Actually has to be careful here, does of course have the Aegis, but doesn't want to use it willy-nilly, although speaking of using their lives willy-nilly, Ace may be the one in that bucket, taking a lot of damage there, glimpsed backwards, trying to omelet toggle the safety, unable to. Will go down, ping attack in trouble as well. I think it's worth it just to die here and burn the Aegis. Especially since Pingvacek only has another minute and 10 seconds or so on that Aegis. Oh, there's gonna be the glimpse back onto Ryze. Danish Bears giving up so much gold. Ryze will fall. And this, probably just those couple of kills, 3,000 gold swing easily, given the state of the game. We can take a look. Net worth being down sharply. You can hear Puck is trying to get some action on, pushing out the creep wave. Then. Well, trying to do what she can, trying to pick up Kiza. He is bottling up. The scream will be enough. Ping attack. Gonna have the Aegis end there, get the regen out of it, so that's something. Aegis, it's a short respawn, it looks like that clock just said. Danish Bears again. They gotta find some way to get something done with regards to towers, because if this game is held out by Broodmothers, they win with the PL, who's got the defusal up. Aghanim Scepter and Gem and full Pipe of Insight finished on the Nightstalker. They've got a lot of tools there. The Veil is up on Noia, as is a 4-star. Glimmer Cape as well. Done on Ryze, and we already saw that 10-second BKB charge used by the Cloth. Oh, glimpse backwards. An interesting play there coming out from Ryze. Well, coming out onto Ryze, but looks like for Danish Bears, they're still searching. And they really don't have something that can go late, so. Mothers just sitting up on their high ground. It's really hard. We talked about this all day yesterday, but it's really hard. Dota's all a game about punishing mistakes, and when you're in your base, it's hard to make those mistakes. Kiza going to get silenced up, has to take the Macropire as well, standing in the ice vault. Going to be able to walk out, but they've got a Fiend's Grip onto Ill. They need to kill someone. They've used a lot of spells here. The Dream Coil comes out. Puck jumps in aggressively, shows up that BKB, gets Primal Ward, but of course does have a Sonic Wave. No, doesn't actually, for 13 more seconds. Buyback on the Disruptor. They have killed up the Beast Monster as well. Static Storm, they're just dropping it on the Nightstalker. There's a little maybe edge here where he can get out, but instead he's going to fall. The Gem is on the deck, and Quoth never found that Sonic Wave spacing. And that's going to be a Gem turned over to Broodmothers. Another 2,000 gold swing their way, despite the buyback. 2,000 gold. And Danish Bears, this feels like it could be bringing back bad memories. She's hunting in the night with that invis, trying to find something. There's gonna be a primal roar instead out onto Ace. Quap jumps in, is silenced up here. Finger check, of course, does have that BKB, doesn't want to use it. And Ace actually uses his dare, just picking off this beast monster. Gonna kill his menagerie afterwards, too. Here comes the push. Finally, there's the pipe. Relax, getting blown up. They may have Ace in the static storm. Bounty Hunter fires back as well. There is a gem on the deck. Ace in a lot of trouble here. Will have to be very careful. Manages to get it off. He won't be going down. And that tower, they do bring it down to half health. All on through from the puck. Ace completely out of range of it. They are surging forward. They want to find something, but there's no Dream Coil. Ping protected. Sonic Waves only on the puck. Should be able to bring him down the macro player. Keezer is going to be just fine. Lance is coming out from the PL. Relax, standing there, trying to track up whoever he can, but Ace feeds down the Disruptor. No buyback on that hero. The PL is getting very low on the sidelines too. Scream forwards manages to pick him off. He does not have buyback. Relax, standing there. One more auto attack will go down. And none of these heroes have buybacks. In fact, there are no buybacks full stop on Broodmothers. Oh, gonna jump into a little bit of trouble. Throws the silence out onto Kizo. Pingachek no longer has that BKB, but here comes the rest of the team. Pingachek will blink away and go down. That is a long godlike streak going the way of the puck. Does give puck buybacks. Puck gonna glyph and buyback. Does not have Dream Coil. They do have Axis and a couple of creeps. They pop the Necro Books, trying to keep folks off of the tower, but it's not enough. And now they're working off the melee racks. Macrophyre coming out, Slytherin Crush to kill off the creep wave. But Danish Bears decide to back on out. They don't have a choice though, but the four star forwards. You can glimpse Noya back all you want, but your kinetic field's not gonna hold him. A nice self-four stop there by Noya. Nighttime as well being popped. Puck still trying to find something. There's another glimpse backwards. There's gonna be a BKB coming out from Ace. Slithering Curse completely off the mark, but he doesn't have to take the silence here, and he's hitting like a truck. Ace is going for the TP away. He wants nothing to do with this business. Ryze trying to find a hiding spot here. PL saw him on the edge there. Ryze goes up into the trees. Oh gosh, if only he'd gone further up into the trees, he maybe could have juked them. Maybe could have found something, but now he is going to fall. And again, another track kill. All of these really big kills for Broodmothers, and they just lost their tier 3. They have to keep holding out here.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Danish Bears, they are on the defensive, but they are the much stronger team. The gold lead is still 20,000 net worth in favor of them. There is just the screen forward, Sonic Wave to finish him off. Orchid as well for good measure. Pingachek will get silenced up here. Jakiro coming in as well. Slytherin Curse is off the mark. That's the real one. Quap figures it out. She knows which one is the real foe, because they all thought that he managed to doppelganger up the hill, but he wasn't so lucky. They're going to see him roll the ice fog off the mark. Focus just falls to Totem Fight, and he will go down again. And Ace glimpsed backward, not going to be able to catch out on Ill. But this is their time. They're going to take the Roshan, see what they can do.
Radiant's top tower is under attack. Roshan has fallen to the Radiant.
Eternal lives.
Well. And Aegis going over on to the Slaughter this time, not the Quap. Oh. And even though they've been doing a good job, Broodmothers have done some defenses. It's just not enough. Gonna get caught out here by the Night Stalker. Uses the Yules. Is gonna just be okay. Also seeing Quap blinking away. Oh no, Puck, I thought you joined it back to your base, but Puck instead going deeper in. A lot of trouble, drops the Dream Coil, but there is no follow-up for Kiza. Then the Static Storm ill places will not let him TP out. Skanks will. We'll see the Beast Monster escape. Base. Looking for someone in the tree line, finding no one. Gonna have to be forced out by Noya.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Rotten, gonna begin work on this Rax. Finally, Danish Bears might be able to break the base after what felt like an incredibly dominant game. Still taking them 30 minutes to get up there. That is part of the problem with their draw. They don't siege terribly well. Jakiro already going to work on the bottom lane, trying to put them in a better position, but of course needs a little bit of help from his friends. And here they go. Made mincemeat of the towers. Oh, the Rax in middle. Now gonna work on this tier 3. It's gone. Jumping forward. There's a Slytherin crest. Ill 3 hits. Bash down. Doesn't have to worry about any of that magic with that BKB active. And suddenly another lane of Rax going the way of Danish Bears. It's not looking like Broodmothers are able to stop this dominant performance. The mech comes out completely negating the desperate shuriken. Bounty Hunter through. But now four Danish Bears. They could go up here. They're gonna go get the creep wave, it looks like, deciding two racks are enough for them now. But again, net worth growth, 30,000 in favor of Danish Bears, 25,000 experience as well. Teams don't come back from these types of deficits. Full Shivas. Pingachek now making a helm. Gonna add some lifesteal to that beast. Gonna stop becoming a right clicker. Doesn't ever want to go down here. The only one on their team with like normal items for them is the Bane, who is actually incredibly poor compared to the rest of the team, but of course, actually really rich for a Bane at this point in the game. Should be sitting closer to the Disruptor's net worth. Bounty Hunter trying to find something, anything to do. Does still have that stolen gem. They bought a new one? So, Noya, you know, they're filthily rich. Noya doesn't care about buying a few extra gems. Puck has those raindrops on him. Looking like Danish Bears have decided this is their time, this is their window, they're gonna go for it. Slaughter still has the Aegis only for another 30 seconds, so it's probably gonna play very aggressively here. PL beginning to, well, Tracks going out, PL should be throwing out monsters. There we go, one thrown out onto Noya, jumped in by the Puff, managed with the Silent Scream, but BKB's immediately popped. Three are caught in the Static Storm, but of course BKB doesn't care about that. Beast Monster will have to buy back, they've already taken down the Disruptor. Focus taking a lot of damage here, the Slytherin Crush just blows up the Bounty under a few more auto attacks, the gem is on the deck, Orb on turn, Puff trying to get bashed, manages to stop getting bashed. There is the Aegis being reclaimed. Quap on the other side of the fight takes it over, and there are the GGs. Danish Bears will be playing in that second phase of the Stall Ladder qualifiers, and unfortunately for Broodmothers, they will go home empty-handed. Well, folks, that's going to be it for today. This is the only game, I believe, as I said, that squares away this group for the European bracket. It's